Mask wearing is now compulsory in parts of Melbourne, and if you're caught without a mask, you face a hefty fine. So should New Zealand adapt the same measure? For his thoughts, we're joined by Otago University's public health professor Michael Baker. Morena, and wow, can't see you behind your mask. Hello.
Morena.
So how does it feel to be wearing a mask on public television?
I'm just getting a bit of practice in case I need one. But New Zealanders, as we know, we're just not used to wearing these things.
No.
But they're actually a great precaution to have available if we get a resurgence in New Zealand. And we think this should be part of our resurgence planning, and that every New Zealander should have a mask at home and know how to use it and when to use it.
Why is New Zealand not putting masks into our resurgence plan?
I don't know, because virtually every country in the world now has masks as a key part of their control measures. And of course, in New Zealand, we don't need to wear masks except in a few specific situations at the moment, like in healthcare or say if you're at borders and you're looking after people arriving from overseas and in the managed care and isolation facilities. But virtually every country in the world now has masks as a key control measure. And we think every New Zealander could have one of these at home. In fact, why not get all the school children in New Zealand to start making these for themselves and their families? I mean, my wife made this last night for me. It took about 20 minutes. It's just a bit of recycled fabric and some elastic. They're very easy to do.
And so just any old piece of fabric, tuck something that's going to hold it on your ears, and you've got a mask that's going to protect you or people around you. Is that right?
Exactly, yeah. It's particularly to protect the people around you. And this is the idea of mass masking, that if you have an outbreak, if we suddenly found after this bulletin that an outbreak had been detected in South Auckland, might already be affecting scores of people, and it was spreading rapidly as it did in Victoria, then if everyone in Auckland was instructed to wear a face mask in all indoor environments like public transport and shops and so on, that may be enough to avoid the need for a lockdown.
New Zealand is notorious for feeling slightly embarrassed if they're standing out from the crowd or they're doing something a bit different. Do you think this is why our leadership is hesitating to try and push this on us?
Well, I think it's, again, it's one of these precautions. But if, as we're seeing in Victoria, you had an outbreak, I think everyone would realise the benefits of wearing masks. The trouble is, unless we build it into our planning now, it's going to be very difficult to suddenly start doing it if we have an outbreak.
The lack of masks in our resurgence plan isn't the only thing that you would like New Zealand to have a look at in terms of our COVID-19 response. You've written a recent blog. What was the main issue, apart from masks, that you have identified?
Well, I think the single biggest thing New Zealand needs to do is now have an official inquiry into our response so far and really look at all of our approaches and our institutions, our laws and our systems for managing this, because we're in it for the long haul now. It may be at least 6 months, maybe 12 months or longer before we have vaccines and decent treatments. So we should pause now and I think just reflect on what we need to get us through the next stages. And a key thing, of course, is our ability to contact trace very rapidly. And I think we do need to look at things like digital assistance, like smart cards and so on, to make that work more effectively.
Thank you so much, Michael Baker, for your time this morning, and thank you for keeping the crew in Wellington safe with your use of a mask. We appreciate it.
Thank you.